What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? Silent Bike back with another video. We're gonna hop in maybe more of a social conversation today. I don't like to think it's political or anything like that, but it's something I've personally observed in my journey through the gym, whether I'm working or lifting over the last 10 years, 15 years, and just on the internet, Instagram, social media, and these kind of things. And that's how women have been training more for performance, more for themselves, and are more often in the free weight section than they were 10 years ago. And also the gap that may still be there in the social pressures for both a male and a female within the gym. Before we dig into it, man, check out my Twitch stream. Is going on almost every single day. If you guys like video games, or if you want to talk fitness, you want to talk life, sometimes we're just there hanging out. I got a brand new podcast every Wednesday, 50% Facts, that goes into detail on specific topics for each question that we try to answer within the podcast weekly with the world's leading experts. So be sure to check that out on Spotify, iTunes, etc. Let's see if we can get 1,000 likes on this video. New video every Monday, Thursday. I appreciate you guys. Let's dive in. So basically, I found an article online. Sometimes I'm just searching around, often on Twitch actually, and we're talking to the boys, we're talking to the crew, and we kind of just have a discussion between chat and myself. And I haven't gone over this one in specific, but it's from a similar website. I'm not gonna link the website or anything like that. But basically, they start talking about gender gaps in the gym, and women not being confident to go into the gym. And it goes into a couple different cultural things. But basically, they list a couple of different lifters, a couple of different athletes that grew up with no sport background, nothing of that nature. And they talk about never even once thinking about I'd go into the weight room. They'd see guys lifting with their cutoffs and being so intimidated that they would never feel comfortable going in there with that testosterone-filled room. And they interview a couple ladies that kind of felt that way up until their earlier mid-20s, and then eventually either found a different inspiration from a teacher or a lifter or a coach that was into powerlifting or something, some type of training, heavy training, and that really inspired them, and they dove deep into that. And on my personal experience, you know, I preach powerlifting not because I want to be a world record holder or I love competing in powerlifting. I preach powerlifting because I do think it's one of the best activities for everybody, for confidence, for health, for healthy hobbies and community, to be able to train day in and day out under a very monotonous sport, to be honest, really trains you mentally and physically. And again, obviously, the resistance training itself has numerous health benefits that can help so many different people. And it's easily addicting. And I think it's good for the mind also. As soon as you can start to focus on performance, being an athlete, having fun and progressing in the gym, rather than measuring your stomach and body fat and worrying about those things. Right here it says, I'm not going to mention names. I don't know if they want to be known or not. But they said this lady definitely isn't the only woman to feel a sense of gym intimidation. If you've ever set foot in a bro-y weight room and suddenly felt like everyone was judging you, you know the feeling. But it's not just a matter of making women self-conscious. Researchers argue experiences like this contribute to a gender gap in physical activity levels that harm women. It says globally, women are less likely than men to get enough exercise. 57% of men ages 18 and over recommend aerobic activity levels versus 49% of women, according to the data from the Center of Disease Control. When it comes to the number of people who meet guidelines for both aerobic and muscle strengthening activity, the gap widens. Further marginalizing groups have it even worse. In recent studies, young black women were the least likely group to report any physical activity, and even the discriminatory policies trans and non-binary people face in sport and gym environments, experts suspect that their exercise participation rates are even lower. And I think that this kind of goes both ways. I think that it mentions earlier in this article that women have the most social pressure to look a certain way or be a certain weight or have the most internal dialogue about their weight and bodies, whether it be body dysmorphia, et cetera, et cetera. And I think to an extent it does, but I think on the opposite, that these stats are increased because men also feel the social pressures, right? All guys know, like, oh, I'm supposed to be the big burly guy with the big bicep and the big long beard, bunch of tattoos. That makes me a man. And although, you know, it's 2019, a lot of us understand that that sounds so stupid, and lifting weights doesn't make you tough, it doesn't make you a fighter, it doesn't make you a man, it just makes you healthy and really good at lifting a socially constructed barbell with weights on there perfectly made for you to lift. I do think that men from an early age kind of get that vision from the world or society, and that's why it's more likely that men lift weights from ladies. Well, the stigma around there is still that men aren't attracted to muscular women, and muscular women don't be a dude, only dudes have muscles, et cetera, et cetera. And to break it down, quite frankly, you know, it's okay, and I see this on the internet, you know, shout out to the homegirls, Steffi Cohen, you know, Meg Squats. I've been friends with them for many, many years, and I love what they do for the sport, and I love what they do for the sport in general, but I also obviously love what they do for women in the sport, and women not in the sport. That shows them it's okay to lift weights, and it's okay to do whatever the hell you want to do despite what these people are putting on you. It's okay in this world to have sexual preferences, and it's okay to have what you like and what you don't like. What's not okay is to mention that on Instagram every single day, to mention it on YouTube every day, and comment like they freaking care. You going on Meg Squat's thing and telling her she's jacked and that's gross is so stupid. It's okay to not have a sexual preference. If you're not sexually attracted to women that have muscle, that's absolutely fine. That's between you and who you may try to date or find in a mate. For you to portray that or project that on Meg is not okay. That's absolutely stupid. The old school thing, right? Like, guys, you like brunettes or you like blondes. It's okay that you're more attracted to blondes. That's totally fine. What's not okay, and this doesn't happen, even though it's the exact same thing you just did on the internet, you don't go up to every brunette on the street or that you see in the mall or that you see in the bar and say, "You're brunette, that's gross. I'm not attracted to that. Ew." You would never do that, and it makes zero sense to do that because that woman, that person doesn't care if you like brunettes or not. And the same fact cares for a confident woman like Meg, like Steffi, like numerous others on the internet or in real life. They don't care that you don't like their muscles. They didn't build their muscles, their strength, their confidence for you. And so for you, and I know a lot of you guys watching aren't these people, because the people that are watching are more informed, they're more into the sport, and they're more open-minded, in my opinion, that are likely to seek out, hopefully, my content and the content of someone like Steffi or Meg. And I'm just using them as examples because I've seen it across the board on the internet, and it's just absolutely stupid. And some people on the internet even say that, like, "Oh, you dyed your hair blonde, gross." No one cares what you freaking think. You know what I mean? It's absolutely stupid. You would never say that to someone on the street. So why are you projecting and throwing your opinion on them? Side rant ante, but it does really piss me off. What's the responsibility of the gym gap? The answer is complex, but a major factor is that active spaces are plagued by gender-specific deterrents that encourage women to stay on the sidelines. We're going to dig into that in a second. And I know all this sounds kind of negative, and man, we're not open and don't let girls train. And there are always things that we can fix and progress, and I think this hopefully is going into it, and we're going to dig in there. But I have noticed over the last 10 years, both males and females are more comforting of each other in the gym and less judgy. There's still, of course, the guys grunting in the corner, you know, curling 10-pound dumbbells, doing their thing and judging everybody in there. But I have noticed going to similar commercial gyms over the last 10 years, and I've been to hundreds, if not thousands, of gyms in my travels with podcasting, et cetera, over the years. There are way more people focusing in on strength, focusing in on performance, and way more ladies in the free weight section now in 2019 than back in 2007 when I started really taking training seriously. For starters, women are more likely than men to experience weight stigma, which can discourage women from going to the gym and even the doctor's office. Then there's the issue of harassment, as in most public places, women experience in gyms and on hiking trails and running routes are often marred by harassment. While running in a busy park in Salt Lake City, Shauna, 26, was followed by a man in his car. He would park, watch her run past, drive up ahead and park to watch her. I mean, that's just next level harassment, and I know it happens, and me, because I'm male and in different situations, I've never experienced that, but that's insane to me, and it absolutely sucks. And we can't, as a group of lifters, as a group of content creators, as a community here on YouTube, we can't really control how weird the world is because the world is so freaking big. But what we can control is what happens within the weight room, within the gym, and we can make sure situations like this aren't gonna happen. We can make sure that we're comforting and freaking just be normal in the weight room to allow women to feel comfortable in the weight room so they don't have to go out there and be harassed. And I understand they should 1,000,000,000% be able to go for a run, a jog, and not think twice about creepy guys on the street following them, watching them, whistling at them, making comments at them. But on a smaller picture, and I can't control that, none of us can. If we could, I would snap and eliminate all those creepers from the freaking world so all the women felt safe doing any activity they wanted to do. But what we can do, I think a small step is us, we have a lot of guys here, a lot of ladies here that are into the gym. We can make everybody feel more comfortable in the gym. Obviously, it's a smaller scale than what's going on out there. And this goes back to my point of just being freaking normal. Even in the gym, I've seen tons of cute girls in the gym. You guys have seen a bunch of different humans you're attracted to in the gym. Don't stare. Don't go talk to them. Don't go hit on them. Let them do their workout in peace. You do your workout in peace. And if the stars align and you see them later at a bar, then it's your time to freaking ask them on a date or something like that. But in the gym, let's all just focus on ourselves, focus on getting better and leaving the rest of the freaking people alone. I wonder if this is actually freaking... Oh my God, I thought Steffi was in this article because it says Stephanie Cohen, but it's spelled differently. This person's a University of Nottingham in the United Kingdom. I was about to say, this is sick. I'm talking about a homegirl, Steffi, and she's in the article. One of the discouraging factors keeping women from working out is hiding in plain sight, the actual designs of most gyms, and social attitudes they reinforce. If you close your eyes and think of the gym, the imagery that often comes to mind is vividly gendered, says Steffi Cohen, PhD and assistant professor at the University of Nottingham. Picture weight racks dominated by sweaty dudes while women are corralled near the cardio machines and stretching areas. I have often been the only woman working out in the room of 15 to 20 men. And I think a lot of ladies probably watching here have felt very similar. But we can change that. We can change that. The guys that are in the weight room can be more welcoming. They can be more normal. They can be less aggressive. You're not a tough guy because you freaking lift weights. You can be more nurturing to the fact that the weight room and free weights should be for everyone. Not all of us can play in the NBA. Not all of us can play competitive athletics as we get older into our 20s and 30s. But all of us can lift weights and get better for ourselves. And that's the most important thing here. I read this article earlier today, maybe even yesterday, and it just really kind of hit the home on what a lot of us, I think, already know and already believe. And then I started just remembering training in the gym in 2007 and what that landscape looked like compared to now. And although we've made progress, we still have a good way to go because this article is brand new and there's obviously still ladies out there that feel intimidated or don't feel comfortable in the gym. And that's on some of us. I think it's on the lady also a little bit to step up and just say, screw it, I don't care, I'm gonna go work out. But it's on a lot of us to be more welcoming, more helpful, and less creepy to allow people to do what they want to do within the gym. So hopefully, those are just my thoughts, man. Comment below what you guys think on the topic. I know it's a big old social picture and a big societal issue here, and it's probably different state to state, let alone country to country. But those are some things that I've noticed here, and I am lucky enough to grow up in certain areas in California where things are a little bit perhaps more open-minded and open than other places in the world. So I do understand that. But even within my little bubble of my life, I have noticed a difference. So I think we're heading the right direction, but there's still a way to go. I appreciate you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, man. Be sure to give it a thumbs up. I'll catch you in the next one. Salam alaikum. I'm out.